Toastmasters and guests. I was born in an upper middle class family. My father used to open a shop in a wholesale market and he was making good money. So I had a chance to study in the top English medium school of our town, Yari. Teachers of that school were so humble and kind that they never spoke English in that English medium school because they knew the students does not understand English, so I confused them. I was average at studies, but still I was the most famous student of our school. Although I was an introvert person, and in fact still I am an introvert person, and there is a great opportunity for all of you. If someday in a meeting anybody doesn't feel like speaking, just sit next to me and believe me, you won't be bothered. Once in my school, teacher punished me and other two kids. A teacher went for staff meeting and view hours of the class, and I said to other kids that, hey, let's see who can do most of the sit-ups. They both agreed, and when three started doing sit-ups. My friends were weak, they just did 50 of them and they were done. But I was really strong, and I did total of 300 sit-ups. My legs were shivering, I couldn't stand, but I was winner at that time. The same friend took me to my home, I was on their shoulder. My mother asked what happened. They said, teacher punished him. And my mother said, nothing, total silence. But I knew it was the silence before strong. The next day, my mother, who happens to be a simple housewife, came to her school and it was a total massacre. Teacher, madam, and my mother, it was a triple threat match. My mother ended up apologizing to the staff because she is a nice lady and I ended up being famous in the school. And after that in the school, no one touched me. Everything was good, we were happy family, wonderful life, and then great things start happening. My father lost his business due to inheritance issues, and all of our savings were gone because he was in debt. We had to sell our home and we had to live with our grandfather because we couldn't afford rent. That time broke my father so much that nearly every organ of his body wasn't functioning well. One day, my mother pulled out. I just ran to the next room and I just saw my mother, my younger brother and sister. They were crying so loud. And my father was in front of me. On that, he was weeping like a kid. And he was pointing his finger toward the window and I was saying, I don't want to go in there. He was saying there are 2% in the white dress coming out, and he was keep repeating this phrase, I don't want to go with them. And I just went and pulled off the curtain, came back, I cleaned my father's tears, and then my father turned to my mother and said one sentence. That one sentence made my life. That one sentence changed my life and made goals and vision of my life. He said to my mother, ask your father to take care of my kids, they're too young. Those words, my father, turned my world upside down because at the age of 15, I thought the situation of my father was because of his own brother and sister who betrayed him, but I was wrong. The situation of my father was because of us. It was because of me he was worried about. I took the blame. I saw my mother stitching clothes all night long. The voice, the noise of their stitching machine was so painful, irritating. I hated that voice. I went into depression. There was a day I didn't want to get out of my bed. I didn't want to change my clothes, brush my teeth, but I really wanted to do something for my family. At the age of 15, I wrote my first CV. I mentioned every skill that I hate, and I gave double space between the lines and double space between the words, but still my first CV was only half page. Back in 2008, I had done diploma in English language, so my plan was to go to different institutions and ask for the job. The very first place, by the way, I picked 10 of them, and I wore the best dress that I had available at that time, and I went out of my home, and the very first place hired me as a language teacher. At the same time, I did full-time job at my uncle's shop, and I did my intermediate on my own, and after that I wanted to study media science animation, but I was broke, I had no money. So I doubled my effort, somehow I managed to take 4 classes as a language teacher, and then I was in full-time job, 1 part-time job, full-time study, and then your system, it was 18 to 20 hours of work a day. Back in 2015, it was tough, I was working really hard, but somehow I managed to get from that. Back in 2015, I started freelancing as a motion graphic artist, and gradually, it was slow at start, but gradually I started getting big projects. And then, 2 years back, I left my full-time job. Last year, I left my part-time job in university. I got married. I today have 10-month-old son and seem to have a stable financial situation. My younger brother is into culinary arts. My brother is a software developer. My father, now he's as healthy as he can do 300 sit-ups now. And my mother, she is still active. And she won't mind other people's flat mates, so you guys be really careful with me. I still have a backup. That time challenged me to be better than I was. That was tough, painful, but we passed through that. But that chapter for life is closed with a happy ending. But the journey isn't finished yet. The Toastmaster is a new journey for life, and as I shared my story with all of you, I hope to learn a lot from you as well. Thank you.